This level of details is absolutely insane. Guys, I just found something that creates 4K textures for 3D objects that's gonna make you crazy. This is really outstanding level. Hey guys, this is Steph, and today we're gonna take a look on new YVO3D that is currently on beta but already accessible, and we're gonna take a look on textures. Guys, this is something really, really, really cool. I was playing around today and I knew I need to record this video ASAP, guys, for you to test, because this is something incredible. They do have free generations available, but to test the 4K, which we'll do in this video, you need a paid subscription plan, but that's totally fine because the quality is really worth it. You can take a look on their examples in their X account. I'm gonna show you some tests I did. We're gonna compare it with Hunian and Prism models. We're also gonna look on some example developer provided, and in the end of the video I will show you how you can improve your textures even further using AI tools. Okay guys, first of all, what we need to understand, this AI is not really about 3D geometry. It's about texturing, and for some textures like characters, etc., it doesn't really give nice results. We need to know that. But for some objects, it's insane. So I generated a few examples of realistic images, and let's take a look. So let's start with this image. It is an earth that looks as a marble ball. So first, let's take a look how Hunian and Prism will do the job. So here is the 2.5 Hunian with textured BBR enabled. So we can take a look. A little bit strange shading here, right? But yeah, that's Hunian specific. Well, not bad, but it's not very close to reference, right? In terms of textures, which we compare right now. Okay, let's take a look on Prism. Little bit better, because there is no this strange flat shading. In some areas it's quite nice, but in some areas it's very blurry, etc. So overall, not bad. But now let's take a look what YVO3D can do. And here we go, guys. Look at this. This is fabulous. This is absolutely amazing. I never thought that so far, so quick, we're gonna get on this level when textures are so, so nice. Wow. So look, and this is PBR texture, meaning like there is a roughness and metallic mumps already here. Look at the shades. Wow. Yes, it's not perfect. It's not a real earth. And the reference is also generated, but the quality of details and the 3D model and texture itself is amazing. Okay, let's take a look at the next example. Okay, so I rendered this nice looking onion with cut. So let's see how it looks. Okay, so here is the result from Prism. Actually, very nice. Maybe because onion is glossy, and you see like the PBR here is not bad, but we can see that is simple, right? There is not really much details, even though it looked good. Okay, here we go with Hunian. Well, it's definitely not that good, and there is no cuts. It's not within the geometry, so yeah, we can say like so-so, but yeah, that's Hunian. And now, here we go with YVO3D. Guys, look at this. It's just amazing. Look how much details. It's like I can actually feel the texture of the onion and the cut. Look, it looks so natural. Wow, this is amazing. And how about bananas? So let's take a look on Hunian. Okay, so well, bananas is actually not bad. So I can see a PBR, this sort of rips. Not bad. Okay, so let's take a look how Prism do that. And I guess like too glossy, but if we remove the PBR, the texture itself is not that bad. But again, if we're starting to zoom in, whoa, this is actually a little bit of an artifact, right? And here's the result of our guest of honor. Just look at this. When I just zoom in, and I mean, it's like I have a close look to a banana in real life. Wow, so much details. Yet, you can see there are artifacts. There are 3 bananas, by the way, not 4, and there is no artifacts within the geometry, but there is a texture artifacts. This still exists. But in general, this is amazing. Guys, before we continue, please subscribe and hit the like button. It will let me know that you actually appreciate my content, and I will do more more for you. Guys, I'm gonna be honest, some models are showing worse results. So in my previous video, we were creating characters with Prism, and look how clean it is here. And I tried to test the same characters here, and unfortunately, it is not that good. So I assume they have a different training data. And you can see by yourself, it has some significant artifacts, and Hunian, Prism, Rodin do not have these things. Even though they have worse textures, but the characters, well, you probably use another models. Same goes for a style character. Even though from some views, it looks really good, but in reality, it really messes up with characters a lot. So you can see, for example, with this character, you know, it painted the pants and jacket in the same texture and the same pattern as a skin, right? As a fur. And yeah, this is not a model I'm ready to use. And compared to our previous test, they were quite nice. But if we take a look on some realistic stuff, this is amazing. Like, this pile of wood looked just absolutely stunning. Look how good it is. Just look how good it is. This is a moss on top, and I mean, guys, wow. This is a game ready asset. I mean, like, you can use it in your videos and in games and anywhere. Like, this is really, really good. Here are also some amazing examples from developers. They really show how good they can create realistic characters like skin, faces, etc. And this is really, truly an amazing state of art performance. Some ancient objects, they look really, really good. Look at this. Look how many details there is. It's crazy, right? It's just crazy. Like, look how many details there are. That's just amazing. Yeah, I can assume that they have a different training data set, some sort of scans, I don't know. But again, I'm really happy that this tool reached the market, because in some cases this might be so nice. Now, for you guys who actually watched this video till the end, one tip about how you can improve textures even further. So let's say we created these bananas, and there is this annoying artifact in the middle, and basically the model is almost perfect, and I just need to fix this one. How do I do that? Do I need a 3D artist? Do I need a special software? No, you don't, because I have a tool specially for you. I'm doing that with the tool called 3D AI Studio, and they have that amazing tool, Texture Painter. So we're gonna go there, and here you can upload your GLB model with the texture, even if my 3D object here with 4K it supports it. So for example, there is Rodin with the same functionality, but unfortunately, to use texture tool, I need to reduce the poly count, etc. Here it's much easier. You just drag and drop the model, and here it is. So how it works is actually very simple. We gonna find the view like this, for example, where we can actually see the artifact, and we can press generate texture. So what it will take, a screenshot of that view and created image where this artifact will probably be eliminated. If it's not, we can adjust the creativity a little bit more. For the model here, I use Flux Texture EI Experimental. Let's give it another try. All right, so here you see the texture here is now updated. So now we have a brush. I will adjust a brush size, so you can see here it's on top of this. And I will adjust the brush range, and I can just slightly move it on top of this space. Boom, 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 boom. Guys, and there is no artifact. So guys, it took me just a few seconds. If you're not happy with some other areas, guys, just rotate the model by pressing your right button, press generate texture, take a look here. You can adjust the prompt, you can adjust these settings like for better results. So you can see this area here now look much clearer. Let's paint it here. Boom, it's done. Guys, I don't know how you can live with this tool right now. This is simply amazing and saves plenty of time. Thanks a lot for your attention. Please don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button, and I see you in the next video. Bye.